Hi. In this chapter, we will talk about advent of digital communication systems. First, we will look at overview of SS7 signaling scheme. Next, we will move on to design criteria of typical telecommunication system. We will follow it up with evolution of the switching systems, in which we will see space switching, electronic switching, message switching, circuit switching, packet switching. We'll round it off with a brief overview of ISDN. Now, specifically in this section, we will deal with overview of SS7 signaling scheme. We have already seen the role of SS7. Now, in detail, we'll look at where SS7 is used, and we'll give a brief introduction for SS7. And later on, we will look at SS7 in detail, in particular the network elements, architecture, the messages that flow in SS7 signaling, typical call flows, and a database query based call flow, the protocol architecture, and a billing card call flow. After that, we'll briefly look at design criteria for a typical telecommunication system. Where all SS7 is being used. We know SS7 is an essential backbone of today's communication networks worldwide. In future, SS7 will continue to be critical for packet-based next generation networks also. The SS7 protocol today is globally used in almost all kinds of telephone networks throughout the world to provide call control and to support intelligent networking applications. SS7 is a key element in enhanced services platforms such as voice over IP, VoIP, and central office switching platforms. This presentation attempts to provide a complete overview of SS7 protocol and the intelligent network and describes several typical SS7 applications. Let's begin. Where do we use SS7 in telecommunications? The answer is too long. A better question would have been, where do we not use SS7 in telecommunications? That would have been a better question and simple to answer perhaps. Have a look at the applications. Just keeps popping on and on in the screen. We have seen various possibilities of SS7 applications. By now you would realize SS7 is the dominant data communications protocol used by the telephone networks to control signaling activities related to call setup and call routing. SS7 also provides services such as 800 number toll-free routing, wireless roaming, and call management services such as calling number display. SS7 offers reliable, faster, and advanced telephone network management functions than ever before. Okay, having seen a little bit of introduction into SS7, let's look at what is intelligent network. The intelligent network is an architecture for implementing intelligence and advanced service functions in the telephone network. The IN architecture uses SS7. One advanced feature an IN would support is the local number portability, LNP, which permits subscribers to retain the same phone number irrespective of which service provider they currently belong to. The number you have got 10 years back through a particular service provider would be the same number you would use today in spite of the fact that you have switched 3 service providers. Intelligent network enables PSTN companies to implement a more uniform set of services across the world. Examples could be caller ID, 800 toll-free number, LNP, one number, follow me, and so on and on. We will continue with SS7 introduction in this slide also. Let's quickly recall how various elements interact in a typical PSTN call. PSTN, as we all know, uses circuit switching mode of connection. It operates on medium bandwidths and has symmetrical path both ways. The delay is low and constant throughout the duration of the call. The error rates are acceptably low. There are three phases of connection. 1. The connection is set up upon the numbers dialed. 2. The call is set up by establishing a communication path end-to-end exclusively between the calling and the call party. 3. Once the call is over, all the circuits in the path are released for reuse by someone else. Let's now recall the role of signaling in PSTN. Connection setup and disconnect phases are achieved through signaling. Setup is done on hop-by-hop basis, starting from the originating switch all the way up to the terminating switch. Disconnection is also done exactly in the similar sequence. Signaling is carried out by conveying the called number through a string of digits. It could be pulse or DTMF. In channel associated signaling, each trunk circuit has its own signaling path. Speech and signaling are in the same path. In common channel signaling, the signaling is in separate trunks and the speech is in separate trunks. Migration from CAS to CCS. What is this? With the advent of digital networks, both in transmission and switching, channel associated signaling was just not adequate. ISDN began this process with digitization of local loops. The need for new efficient signaling was felt. A new methodology called common channel signaling or message based signaling was introduced during 1980s. This was quicker and newer additional services could be introduced, which made the customers very happy and spoiled them, in fact, by increasing their expectations. To meet these needs, SS7 is the most widely used form of CCS today. Some implementation details. SS7 network is an overlay network to PSTN. SS7 was implemented in layered manner. TUP and ISUP were at the top of the hierarchy. Additional functionality like SECP, TCAP were introduced to overcome some shortcomings. Layered approach makes us talk of SS7 protocol stack. Backward compatibility allows signaling to be partly on CCS network and partly on CAS networks also. In this slide, let's look at an overview of SS7 signaling scheme. Let's look at SS7 signaling as an introduction. Look at the figure. A typical PSTN switching sequence is shown in this figure. In this configuration, signaling has a different route and speech has an altogether different route. The signaling overlay is known as SS7, Signaling System 7, which is a very popular standard used throughout the world. SS7, as you can see, is common channel signaling. If there are 1000 subscribers in a local exchange shown, all their signaling will go through a common network called SS7 signaling network. The SS7 analyzes the signaling information, typically it could be digits received, and determines a destination and sets up a path end-to-end. Then, it sets up the conversation between the calling and the call party through separate lines, which could be local loops, trunks, etc. Of course, maintenance of this call, disconnection and billing also will be the responsibility of SS7 network. In this section, as we go along further, we will see SS7 in great detail. It's the most popular global common channel standard. We will begin this SS7 by seeing where all SS7 is being used. We will take a peek at the various elements in a PSTN network as an introduction to SS7. We will then look at SS7 architecture, the purpose behind SS7, and its important features in detail. The various messages that are part of SS7 will be described next. An ISUP call flow will be seen next. We'll discuss some important messages of SS7 and also the protocol architecture. We'll conclude the SS7 session by seeing a typical call flow of a prepaid calling card and some elementary design criteria. Over to SS7.